Listen to me. You're never going to be perfect. Nobody's perfect. I mean, it's impossible to be perfect. If perfect is even a thing, our aim shouldn't be towards being perfect. It should be aimed towards progress. Because that type of extreme thinking leads to nothing but depression. Because whatever you do, it'll never be enough. Because you'd be trying so hard to be what you can't be, which is perfect. Perfectionism is a form of resistance. Remember what I said resistance was? Resistance is something that impedes our ability of becoming who we want to become. So it stops us from doing what we want to do. So it's considered resistance. It's a force that's stopping you from moving forward. And that's what perfectionism is. Because what perfectionism does is stagnates your imagination and creativity. It stops you from really trying new things because you'll never really do these new things to perfection. So in your mind, you'll think, why try? Why even do it? I'm not going to be successful at it anyways. So it's a form of resistance. Or you can look at it in this sense. There's many things that I know you guys have wanted to do in your life, but you never did it because you felt like you were going to be overly criticized by your peers, or you just felt that you weren't good enough, or you couldn't do it. You didn't have the intelligence, or you didn't have the creative ability to do it, to get the job done. So in essence, you didn't do it in the end because you were subconsciously trying to live up to this idea of being perfect. If I'm going to do it, then I have to be the best at it. I have to be perfect. You can be the best at it without being perfect. Michael Jordan is one of the best at playing basketball. LeBron James is one of the best at playing basketball, but they're not perfect. LeBron can't shoot free throws. Jordan didn't have a great 3-point shooting percentage. In order to be great, you don't have to be perfect. You just got to be great. You got to be the best. You got to be one of the best. You just have to be great at what you do. You can strive for perfection, but you still have to understand that you'll never be perfect. But I can, you know, try to be the closest thing to it. That's how you got to view it. Because if you view it that way, that entices you to work hard, to be near perfect. You know, you'll never get it. But I know if I work harder, I'll be better than everybody else, which is close enough. It doesn't strike you out mentally. It doesn't take you away from working hard, because trying to be perfect takes you away from actually doing the job, actually doing the thing. So when I used to make music years ago, 7 years ago, I used to be super critical of myself. I used to, you know, say whatever I needed to say in the mic. And then I used to replay and be like, nah, I didn't say that right. I have to re-say it. It didn't come out of my mouth correctly. When you look at other people, when you judge their art or their creative form or creative passion or whatever it is that they do, you don't tend to judge as harshly as you would if it was your art or if it was your work, because you tend to see all the flaws. That's the perfectionism in you. That's you wanting everything to be perfect, but it won't be. You got to get to a point to where you say, I'm okay with how this came out. I'm good with how this came out. It isn't perfect, but I know it's better than everybody else's. You know, so you got to get to that way of thinking. I had to learn that I'm not perfect at what I'm doing. You know, I'm not perfect at making music. You know, there's going to be subtle, you know, problems. There's going to be subtle errors that I make in the music. I may not pronounce a word fully, and you may hear that, and you may not. Most of the time you won't. I hear it because it's my art form. I created it, so I can see and hear all the imperfection and whatever it is that I'm creating. But I had to get to a point where I stop allowing that to hinder me from allowing myself to grow, allowing myself to develop. Because in order to be successful, you have to make mistakes. You have to create errors for yourself. You have to do things wrong in order to develop, to become great. Success isn't, it isn't something that happens automatically. It's a byproduct of years of you putting in work and years of you becoming better at whatever it is that you do. So you have to make mistakes. You have to come from some type of trial and tribulations in order to become great. So don't worry so much about being perfect your first, you know, time going through things. Just strive to get better. That's what you need to be focusing on. How can I get better every day to where, you know, I'm good. I'm great at what I do. Not perfect, but I'm great at it. So focus on progress every day. Write down how you're making progress every day and whatever it is that you're doing. Track that progress and see how you're getting better. And, you know, by the time you know it, you're going to be great. You're going to be a lot better at everybody else at whatever it is. So knock that perfection mindset out, because there's no way you're going to be perfect. It's impossible to be perfect. But you can work hard to be as close as hell to perfect. You know, continue to allow perfect, the idea of perfect, to push you. Allow that to push you, to move you forward, to get you to work harder. But don't allow that word to hinder you, to stop you from progressing, to stop you from even doing whatever it is that you want to do. Don't let it hinder you. Let it push you. So that's all I really have for you guys today. You know, I think we just get so caught up in trying to do everything correctly and not allowing ourselves to make mistakes and not allowing ourselves to grow or not allowing ourselves to develop. So welcome mistakes, welcome your errors, because once you make these kind of mistakes, these kind of errors, now you know not to do it that way. You know, whatever the obstacle is, you understand how to get to where you want to be from going through that obstacle. I know not to do it that way. Next time I won't do it that way. So making the mistake gives you the answer. You know, you have to make the mistake in order to how to do things correctly. So allow yourself to be imperfect, you know, because nobody's perfect, as J. Cole said. But yeah, I thank you guys, and hope you guys having a good day, man. I'm having a great day. But I'll catch you guys in the next one. I'm out.